Hi, welcome back to Expo Today Live. We have John Omahan, Vice President of Post-Trade Derivatives at SunGard. Thanks for being with us.
No problem.
Crazy times. We're in the final stretch of Dodd-Frank implementation. What are the biggest challenges you see for firms? I mean, we have a lot of reporting and then all the clearing and a lot more post-trade processing stuff going on.
That's true. And I think one of the toughest parts about this environment is that it has become so complex. And although we maybe are getting further along in Dodd-Frank, there's still a great deal about the trading side of the market, the SEFs and the flows that are still sort of being debated and rules and regulations still to come. So while there is complexity, there's also some uncertainty. And I think that's certainly a big challenge today for everyone.
When there's going to be a certain level of uniformity in how swaps are, you know, just in how collateral is managed and recorded, do you see that the industry is in the right space with that at this point, or are we?
Well, it's interesting when you talk about uniformity in this industry, it's it really only looks uniform from 20,000 feet up. As soon as you get into the weeds, so to speak, you find that everything's a little bit different. Even when you have something as sort of seemingly simple as a trade feed in FixML, you find that one clearinghouse uses it different from another. One SEF might be using it differently from another, or FPML. So there's always nuances, particular to the market and to the product. And as long as we have for-profit clearinghouses, I'm afraid that's probably going to stay the same.
What have you been busy at SunGard with your customers? I mean, what is your biggest project you've been doing with your customers?
Well, you know, I'd say one of the most interesting projects we're working on right now is supporting cross-margining. And I mean that both in the sense of cross-margining as the CME is offering it, and of course cross-margining across markets for customers. So with the CME cross-margining, the ability to group all of your swaps positions with Treasury futures to offset the risk, that presents an incredible opportunity for the industry, especially because it's assumed that margins are going to be higher for everyone. Anything you can do to relieve that stress is obviously getting a lot of attention. The challenging part about it is that it actually seems more straightforward from a risk perspective in terms of how these products leverage out each other. It seems actually more straightforward for that than it does how to operationally support transferring futures positions from a futures type of account into a swaps type of account. And that's something that we're working on right now. And really, in order to make it useful and used in the industry, it has to be something that can be automated and can be rolled out very, very easily for many customers and many trades. So we have to make sure that operational support of cross-margining is not a manual process. If it stays that way, which is sort of the way it is right now, no one's going to be able to use it.
So down the road, we're going to probably see a lot more volume of swaps once things become more standardized and the systems get in place. And I guess that's where firms like SunGard come into place here.
Yeah, certainly, you know, a reason people do use us is because we provide systems that help automate things. And, you know, the more you can automate it, the lower your cost is per trade or per position. And that has led to, I think, a renewed interest lately in straight-through processing. It was a term from, you know, 10 years ago. They got a lot of attention, didn't necessarily live up to its promise. But I think with the swaps coming into the clearing world, a renewed focus has been put on that. And some great strides have been made over the last 10 years in how systems can be automated and how processes can be made more efficient. So that's definitely a big focus for us, and you know, good news for us since we're a software vendor.
Excellent. Well, John, thanks so much for being with us today.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks. Stay tuned. We have a lot more ahead.